Welcome dear students, today we will see how to determine second order reaction rate constant. Aim of today's practical to determine second order reaction rate constant. Requirements: chemicals, 0.04 molar ethyl acetate, 0.01 normal acetic acid, 0.04 molar sodium hydroxide, phenolphthalein indicator and ice. Then apparatus: beakers, reagent bottles, conical flask, constant temperature water bath, weighing balance, then burette, pipette and thermometer. First of all, we'll see what are the chemical kinetics. So chemical kinetics is a department of chemical science dealing with study of rate of reaction and the factors which affect that rate of reaction. So all this study included into the chemical kinetics. Now we'll see reaction rate. Rate of reaction is defined as a change in the concentration of reactant or product per unit time. If there is a reaction of conversion of A to B, then what happens? There is a disappearance of A and appearance of B. So this disappearance of A and appearance of B is nothing but rate of reaction. So we can convert it in terms of equation that dA upon dT is equal to dB upon dT. So negative sign is there with A and positive sign is there with B. This square bracket represents concentration of moles per liter, whereas D represents infinitesimally small change into the concentration. Then negative sign of A shows decrease into the concentration of reactant A, while positive sign of B indicates increase in a concentration of product B. Reaction rate has units for concentration divided by time. So these are the different units of reaction rate. Then we'll move towards the order of reaction. Now today we are going to determine second order reaction rate constant. Before that, we should know what is order of reaction. So it is defined as number of atom or molecule or ions whose order may be zero or integer or fraction. It is also expressed as sum of power of concentration of reactant. According to the law of mass action, if A plus B gives a product, then reaction rate will be K is equal to concentration of A, concentration of B divided by product. Then order of reaction will be sum of power of concentration of reactant. So these are the power of the reactant, A, small a and small b. And its sum, that is small a plus b, gives order of the reaction. There are different orders of reaction: zero order reaction, apparent zero order reaction, first order reaction, pseudo first order reaction, then second order reaction and higher order reaction. Now we'll see what exactly the second order reaction, where the rate of reaction depends on concentration of two reactants. This type of the reaction is called as second order reaction. So in these reaction, rate of reaction is directly proportional to the product of concentration of two reactants. For example, alkaline hydrolysis of methyl acetate, then hydrolysis of chlorobutanol. If initial concentration of A reactant is given into the moles per mole liter inverse, if after time t, x moles of A have reacted and its concentration will become A minus x. A means initial concentration. For such a second order reaction, rate of reaction is proportional to square of concentration of reactant. So a rate of reaction, that is dx upon dt, is equal to k into A minus x for the single reactant, and here we are considering two reactants, that's why A minus x square, where k is constant. By rearranging this equation, we can write dx upon A minus x square, just this A minus x square transferred from right hand side to left hand side, and this dt is transferred from left hand side to right hand side, so their positions are changed. By integrating this equation 2, we'll get 1 upon A minus x is equal to kt plus I, where this I is integration constant. If value of x is equal to 0 and t is equal to 0, then this I will become 1 upon A. So this is equation 4. When we put this value into the equation 3, it will become 1 upon A minus x is equal to kt plus 1 upon A. Okay, instead of this I, here we put 1 upon A. If we rearrange it, it will become k is equal to 1 upon t divided by x. 1 upon t into x divided by A into bracket A minus x. So this is the final equation for the determination of reaction rate constant of second order reaction. This is integrated rate equation and its unit is mole inverse time inverse. Now we'll see a theory behind this experiment. We are going to take ethyl acetate along with the caustic soda, that is NaOH, and there is a saponification, and this reaction is non-reversible. Okay, this is ethyl acetate. Initially its concentration A, then its concentration B, so initially concentration of product is 0, but at time t this A will become A minus x and this NaOH is become A minus x. Why it is so? Because A is equal to B in this case, that's why the concentration after time t will be same. Okay, then we will get a product which is having a concentration x. So rate of reaction is equal to dx upon dt is equal to into concentration of your ethyl acetate into concentration of your NaOH. So here it is A minus X. That's why it will become K into A minus X square. Okay, after a time T from the start of reaction, concentration of ethyl acetate and sodium hydroxide decreases. That's why this X is minus from the A value and it will become A minus X. Since the concentration of both the reactant is same at the beginning, that is A is equal to B, and it is decreased and concentration be a X mole per liter at a time T from the start of reaction, and that's why it is A minus X. When you integrate this equation, you will get K is equal to 1 upon AT into X upon A minus X. So in this way, in this reaction, rate of reaction is proportional with the concentration of ethyl acetate as well as the NaOH. That's why it is second order reaction. Now we'll move towards the next part, that is procedure. Now what you have to do, you have to take a 50 ml of 0.04 molar ethyl acetate. We have to place it in a stoppered reagent bottle. Then add 50 ml of 0.04 molar NaOH in another same bottle and keep this both bottle at a constant temperature bar and note down the temperature. Then transfer the sodium hydroxide from second bottle into first bottle which is containing ethyl acetate. Then check it and note down the time, and this time is T0. Immediately after addition of the sodium hydroxide into the ethyl acetate, you have to withdraw 10 ml of reaction mixture and then transfer it into the conical flask which is already containing 25 ml of 0.01 molar acetic acid as well as cold water or ice, and then titrate this mixture against 0.01 normal NaOH and neutralize excess of acetic acid by using phenolphthalein indicator. Then this will be the V0 value at 0 minute. Then withdraw 10 ml of reaction mixture from a bottle each time. Then transfer into different conical flask at a time T, and that time will be 3 minutes, 6 minutes, 9 minutes, 12 minutes, 15, 20, 25 and 30 minutes. So as per this time interval, you have to withdraw the sample and titrate it against the sodium hydroxide given as per the step give 2. And that reading will be your VT reading. Means after time T, you will get some reading. That readings will be your VT value. Means you will get different VT value for the different time interval. And the V0 value will be the single value at the 0 minute. Then determine V infinity after 1 hour from the start of reaction. Okay, here you don't require to reflux these reaction mixture, just you have to put that reaction mixture 1 hour, then you have to withdraw the sample and then add 25 ml of acetic acid, then 10 ml cold water or ice and titrate it against the 0.01 normal sodium hydroxide using phenolphthalein indicator, and this will be your V infinity reading. So this reaction is very fast even at a room temperature. That's why the V infinity reading may taken after completion of 1 hour from the start of reaction without refluxing. Okay, means here you don't require the reflux assembly, just after 1 hour of start of reaction you can withdraw a sample and titrate it against the NaOH, and this will be your V infinity reading. Okay friends, now we'll move toward the actual demonstration part.
Actual demonstration, how to determine the reaction rate constant for the second order reaction. Now we'll take a quick revision for the procedure. First of all, you have to take a 2 reagent bottle. In first reagent bottle, you have to take 50 ml of 0.04 molar ethyl acetate. In second reagent bottle, you have to take a 50 ml of 0.04 molar NaOH. So these are the two reactants which are going to interact with each other and you will get a product. Now, what you have to do, this 50 ml of NaOH you have to add into the first reagent bottle and immediately you have to withdraw the sample at a 0 value. So likewise, you have to withdraw a sample after addition of this NaOH into the first reagent bottle at a 0 minute, 3 minute, 6, 9, 12, 15, 20, 25 and 30 minutes. Okay? And that 10 ml sample you have to add with 25 ml of 0.01 molar acetic acid and add ice or cold water in these mixture and titrate it against the 0.1 normal NaOH by using phenolphthalein indicator. So same procedure you have to follow for each time you have prepared 0.04 molar ethyl acetate and 0.04 molar NaOH. These are the two reagent bottles. Now I am going to take 50 ml of this NaOH. Into this reagent bottle. Now into this second reagent bottle I am going to take 50 ml ethyl acetate . We are conducting this experiment at a room temperature and that's why no need to keep it into the water bath. Now in these two bottles, 50 ml ethyl acetate and 50 ml NaOH is there. Now I am going to add this mixture, add this NaOH into the first reagent bottle which is having the ethyl acetate. Now immediately I am going to withdraw. Immediately I am withdrawing the 10 ml reaction mixture and adding into the conical flask. When you mix this NaOH with ethyl acetate, immediately you have to note down the time. So this is my first sample. Then I am going to add 25 ml of the 0.01 normal acetic acid. Then mixed chilled water
with this reaction mixture. And then add penicillin indicator and titrate it with NaOH. So end point will be the light pink color. Now slowly this mixture is converting into the light pink color and my burette reading is 23 ml. Now this is my V0 reading. Likewise, I am going to withdraw a sample of this reaction mixture after 3 minutes. Then as per our procedure, I am going to withdraw the sample and titrate it again the 0.01 normal NaOH. So in this way I have withdraw a sample after 3 minutes, 6 minutes, 9, 12, 15, 20, 25 and 30 minutes. Now I am going to add this cold water into each reaction mixture. This cold water I have added to stop the reaction. Means no further proceeding of the reaction should be there. That's why cold water is required. Now I am going to add acetic acid. So 25 ml acetic acid I am adding into this each conical flask. So in this way I have added acetic acid into the each reaction mixture. Now I am going to titrate this third minute reaction mixture with the help of NaOH. Phenolphthalein indicator I have added into this reaction mixture and titrating with the NaOH. So my burette reading is 24 ml for the 3 minute reaction mixture. All this reaction mixture against this NaOH and note down the reading. And at last, after 1 hour I am going to withdraw a sample and same way I am going to titrate it against the 0.01 normal NaOH. And I will note down all these readings.
First of all, we'll see observations. So water bath temperature 25 degrees centigrade, because we have conducted experiment at a room temperature and it was 25 degrees centigrade. Then titer reading, that is V0, means when there is no interaction of this two reactant. At that time, burette reading was found to be 23 ml and it is V0 value. Then V infinity value is when there is a complete reaction after this, when you withdraw a sample and the observed value of ml of NaOH was 52 ml. Then initial concentration of ester 29 ml. Now this is observation table. We have withdrawn a sample still from 0 minute to 30 minutes and these are the ml of NaOH required to neutralize. Here I have calculated x value. Now how this x value calculated? Vt minus V0. Okay, Vt means what? volume of NaOH required to neutralize that reactant mixture or reaction mixture. So Vt minus V0, these are the x values for each time interval. Then here I have calculated A minus x. A is initial concentration and this is the x value. Okay, how we have calculated Vt, V infinity minus Vt. So these are the values for different time interval. Then here I have taken 1 upon A minus x value. Then here 1 upon x minus 1 upon A values. So likewise these values are calculated. Then here we have calculated reaction rate constant. So formula for the reaction rate constant, 1 upon T. T is nothing but this time interval into 1 upon X minus 1 upon A. So by using this formula, we can calculate reaction rate constant. For 0 minutes, observed value or calculated value for the reaction rate constant is 0. For 3 minutes, T is 3 minutes. So 1 upon 3 into 1 upon A minus X for the 3 minutes is 0.035 and 1 upon A is 0.034. Then reaction rate constant after 3 minutes is 0.00033 liter mole inverse time inverse. So same way I have calculated for different time interval. So K value for after 6 minutes 0.0011 liter mole inverse time inverse. Then after 9 minutes, it is 0.001 liter mole inverse time inverse. Then after 12 minutes, it is 0.013 liter mole inverse time inverse. Then after 50 minutes, 0.016 liter mole inverse time inverse. Then after 20 minutes, 0.00185 liter mole inverse time inverse. Then after 25 minutes, 0.00196 liter mole inverse time inverse. Then after 30 minutes, 0.0022 liter mole inverse time inverse. Then here I have calculated average K value. We have 9 values of reaction rate constant with us. I have taken an average of these all these values. So it is 0.0012 liter mole inverse time inverse. Now we'll see how to plot a graph. So here I have plotted a graph 1 upon x minus 1 upon a versus time. So these are the values of 1 upon x minus 1 upon a and these are the different time intervals. So you can consider any two points from the line and calculate slope by using equation y2 minus y1 is equal to x2 minus x1. So the slope value is a reaction rate constant for the second order reaction. That's why this K is equal to 0.0025 liter mole inverse, sorry, liter per mole minute. So in this way we can write a result for the theoretical value as well as the graphical value. So theoretically our calculated reaction rate constant for this reaction 0.0012 liter mole inverse time inverse, and by using graph calculated value or observed value is 0.0025 liter mole inverse time inverse. Now we'll see a questions that will be asked into the synopsis. Which of the following reaction is bimolecular one. Means in which reaction two molecules are there. So correct answer is this option D into O and H2. So these two molecules are taking part into the reaction, that's why it is bimolecular one. Then which one of the following statement about the molecularity of any reaction is correct? First statement, it is experimentally determined. Then it is meant for the reaction and not for its individual step. It may or may not be whole number. It can never be zero. And correct answer is option D, that it can never be zero. Then third question, rate of reaction depends on slow step, fast step, overall reaction, or both slow and fast step. And correct answer is rate of reaction depends on slow step. Molecularity of reaction is 1, 2, half or 3 by 2. And correct option is B. That is molecularity for these reaction is 2. Next question, speed of reaction is constant no matter what the temperature is independent of amount of constant surface of solid involved. Then between gases should in all cases be extremely rapid, because average kinetic energy of the molecules is great. Between ions in aqueous solution is extremely rapid because there are no bonds that needs to be broken. And correct option is option D, that is between ions in aqueous solution is extremely rapid because there is no bonds that needs to be broken. Then next question, what is difference between molecularity and order of reaction? So this is the difference. Order of reaction is nothing but sum of power of concentration terms in an experimentally determined rate equation. While molecularity is a number of molecules, atoms or ions which must collide simultaneously in order to bring about the chemical reaction. Okay, here it is sum of power of concentration terms, and here it is addition of number of molecules taking part into the reaction. Order of reaction can be 1, 2, 3 or 0 or fractional, but molecularity will never be 0, either it is 1, 2 or 3 only. It is an experimental quantity. It is a theoretical quantity and depends on the mechanism of reaction. Then it is applicable to elementary as well as complex reaction. It is applicable only elementary reaction. For complex reaction, order is determined by slowest step, and the order of and molecularity of slowest step are same. But for the complex reaction, molecularity has no meaning. Means if number of molecules are taking part into the reaction, then there is no meaning for the molecularity. So this is all about the determination of reaction rate constant for the second order reaction. Thank you for listening.